Bonjour Neil.
Bonjour.
Thank you for being here today with us. With the Q3 results being out today, we thought it was a good timing to ask you a couple of questions.
No, it's my pleasure. Thank you.
What is your analysis of Q3 results and the revised guidance we issued in September?
Yeah, well, I mean, we were incredibly disappointed that after four quarters of sustained earnings growth and cost reductions and progress on a lot of items, that we encountered some issues with two projects under the same contract in oil and gas in the Middle East.
So what happened exactly, and what's the impact of that revised guidance?
Well, we had to revise the guidance because in terms of our quarterly reporting and our commitment to making sure that we keep the market informed, we really had to come out and make sure that everybody understood that there was revised costs and therefore a deterioration in the profitability of these contracts. But it's not a complete permanent deterioration. We are in dialogue with the customer, a highly professional, long-term customer, about some of the commercial items. So we really hope that through these discussions and progress, we can reverse some of that.
So just to explain a little bit more, the guidance changed from which number to which number?
So we had a guidance of $150-$170, which is the E&C adjusted EPS, and we revised the bottom end down to $130 to take into account some of which we've recognized in this quarter. And the upper end is $160. So that is effectively reflecting the possibility that in Q4 we could recover some of that downside.
So, but we still have a lot of good news in those results this month.
Yeah, well, actually, everywhere else, the business was doing incredibly well. That's why it's, you know, disappointing for myself and, you know, a number of people, because we were doing well in all sectors. In fact, we were doing really, really well in every other aspect of the oil and gas sector. Infrastructure was performing exceptionally well, power was performing well, and mining, whilst it's a smaller part of the business, was also performing well. And of course, the other key metric that we're being measured against is our ability to deliver a $100 million G&A reduction in the year. And at the end of Q3, we've got a reduction of $95 million. So we should be able to easily beat the $100 million target.
So we had very good news in infrastructure and in power as well in the last quarter.
Yeah, I mean, infrastructure, particularly good. We've been shortlisted for three major projects, as well as winning a couple of other projects. And that is, as I said before, it's particularly pleasing because we've got a number of projects that we're currently working on. So, you know, these bids will effectively be done primarily in 2017. So we will be in a really good position when it comes to execution, to be able to transfer people from large infrastructure projects onto these new projects if we win them.
What about in power?
In power, it was very good as well, particularly in the highly attractive sector of nuclear. So there was two major things there. We secured the initial work, engineering work and tooling work for Bruce Power in Ontario. But we also signed a fairly landmark potential JV agreement with the Chinese in Ottawa, which is all about facilitating the opportunities for us to be able to build CANDU reactors, facilities, both in China and potentially in other parts of the world.